Hi everyone, welcome back to Make Me Unusual. If you're new here, thank you for joining us, and if you're not new here, thank you for coming back. Today is another Scentbird review for the month of April. So I have two fragrances. They're not both from the same company, but they're both from companies that I reviewed before. So if you're interested in seeing the two fragrances that I got this month, then stay tuned. So come on, give me love. I'ma show you how to move with my body. Come hit me with your touch and make me wanna say. Okay, so I got two fragrances. One is from Tiziana Terenzi, which we just reviewed. I wanted to try the third fragrance that Scentbird had on the website, so we'll be trying that. But on top of that, I'm trying another fragrance from Skylar. So Skylar Clean Beauty, I did a whole Skylar review of fragrances. So I think that was my first Scentbird review. Maybe, I think so. But they have a new fragrance and it's called Coconut Cove. And if you know anything about me, I love coconut. So in an effort to not blind buy everything, I wanted to get this before the Sephora sale finished, which I did. And as you can see from my Sephora haul, I didn't purchase it. Not because I didn't like it, but we'll get into the review. So Coconut Cove, we're gonna start with that one since I'm talking about it. Let's see. So the coastal wind carries creamy coconut through the green trees to meet you with a tranquil touch, a scent to transport your spirit to an exotic haven on the breathtaking coast. So the highlighted fragrances, or the highlighted notes, are bergamot, coconut, and ambrox. Coconut Cove is not on Fragrantica, and on the Skylar website it still just says bergamot, coconut, and ambrox. So let's give it a sniff. I smelled this once. I think I wore it to the gym. It's good. Okay, it is good. It smells like coconut and bergamot. It is a little different from like your standard tropical coconut fragrance. It's a little bit more on the punchier citrusy side, so it's a little bit texturally different. My issue with it, and the reason I didn't purchase it, it smells like hairspray. like from my childhood, reminds me of a hairspray, and it doesn't smell bad, it just reminds me of hairspray. It smells great. If it didn't remind me of hairspray, I'd be more keen to purchase it, but it smells good. It's a different kind of coconut than I have in my collection, which, I mean, it would add so much to my collection, but it's just too hairspray-y for me. If you don't have that connection, that like nostalgic connection with this scent, then I think if you like coconut and you like lemonade scents, you would like this. But if you have that nostalgic connection, that you, yeah. I mean, you may like it because of the nostalgia, but because of that, I just feel like I smell like hairspray, and I don't know. I'll play around with this more, but once I smelled it the first time, it like stopped me from purchasing it. Because it smelled like hairspray. So Would I buy this? I don't think so. I don't think I'm gonna end up buying it, but I do have a trip coming up, so take it with me and we'll see how it goes. All right, so the other one I got is Orion by Tiziana Terenzi, and I think from what I remember from this, it was more on the masculine side, but Tiziana Terenzi's Orion is inspired by Paolo's time spent in Mount Conero in Italy on the water, sailing with his beloved grandfather, who would always point out the constellation Orion and its mythical belt. It is a spicy, intense perfume, powerful yet delicate. This fragrance is on Fragrantica, so the main accords are fruity, woody, smoky, leather, sweet, amber, fresh, aromatic, fresh, spicy, and oud. Clearly, I didn't read the notes. Top notes are pineapple, apple, bergamot, and red currant. Middle notes are birch, thyme, patchouli, jasmine. Base notes are cedar, incense, oud, musk, amber. So it's like a 50-50 on whether or not I was gonna like this scent. But in the perfume reminds me of section, it is all masculine or masculine pulling fragrances. Not gonna even spray too much because I don't dislike the scent, but I'm not gonna wear this. It is quite heavy on the cedar, thyme, patchouli, jasmine. Like, those middle notes are very much there. Those top notes, I'm getting like none of. I'm getting basically the middle notes, which on the, my goodness, on this card, it's bergamot, spicy note. Spicy tones of patchouli, thyme, agarwood, and cedar, which is pretty much what I smell. But this gives me almost an instant headache, and not like a painful, like a tension headache. It just makes me want to squint my eyes, and yeah. Would I buy this? No. It's very, very, very masculine pulling. It is spicy and woody and patchouli forward. If you don't like that, I would not suggest it. It's a little bit disorienting for me, and I wouldn't wear it. I don't know that I want my boyfriend to wear it either, because it does give me a headache. So would I buy it? No. So that's my thoughts on Orion. Coconut Cove. So this month obviously wasn't successful, but we'll see for next month. I don't know how much longer I'm gonna continue with Scentbird. Not that I don't like the service. I do like the service, because thankfully I've saved like $400 right here, because Tiziana Terenzi is hella expensive, and Skylar Coconut Cove is like $100, which I was going to blind buy. So I have saved money using this service. I think I'm getting through all of the fragrances that I was interested in. So yeah, and a lot of them I've ended up not being interested in. So I don't know how much longer I'm gonna have this service, but it also depends on what they keep adding, and they're doing more niche fragrances, which is great. So we'll see. I do really like this service, and I do recommend it if you are the type to blind buy things. maybe try scent birds so that you can try fragrances beforehand. But yeah, that is everything for the April. Yeah, that's everything for the April scent birds. So if you enjoyed the video, please like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.